Glory be to God. Hallelujah. Amen. It's better you join the winning team. Amen. The world economy is on the collapse. And all over the world, men are panicking. Hallelujah. I remember sometime last year, we were saying that the system of the world is programmed for collapse. Amen. Glory be to God. You better join the winning side. The governments of the world are in panicky mood because the collapse of the financial system, like the world has never experienced before, is just at the brink of taking place. The American government is rushing to see whether they can put in place a package that can salvage the economy. Not the economy, it is the economy of the world, because the economy of the world is hinged on the U.S. economy. Are you getting the point? So if their economy, don't think that if the economy collapses, you're okay. Hallelujah. If the economy collapses, you are also in trouble. Are you getting the point? Because the value of the money you have is in dollars. If their economy collapses, if dollar becomes valueless, that means your money will also become valueless. Are you getting the point? So don't sit down and say it's for them. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. Our confidence is not in any system of the world. Our confidence is in the kingdom of God. Glory be to God. Glory be to God. Jesus said, in this world, you will have what? Tribulation. Tribulation. So any man who refuses to put his confidence in the kingdom of God is setting himself up for tribulation. Hallelujah. Why would you die, O ye man? Why would you die? Amen. I don't know where your confidence is, because if your confidence is in the Lord, you will be excited. Hallelujah. It's so bad that in Hong Kong, men are camping outside banks, waiting to collect their money. Glory be to God. Praise the Lord. Where are you building your confidence? Is it the system that is bound to collapse? Or are you building your confidence in the kingdom of God that is going to be forever and ever and ever? Hallelujah. God said, once more, I am going to shake the earth and the heavens. Everything that cannot withstand that shaking shall be removed. Only those who are standing on this kingdom, this immovable kingdom, will not be shaken. Hallelujah. It's not my cup of tea if the economy of the world should collapse. Praise the Lord. Not my cup of tea. As a matter of fact, we are the ones preaching for it to collapse. Praise the Lord. Amen. You don't know that's the gospel we are preaching. Jesus said, this gospel shall be preached unto the ends of the earth. And then what? The end will come. Hallelujah. So as we engage in preaching this gospel, we are drawing this world to a close. Glory be to God. How many are happy to be a part of this move of God? Hallelujah. Only one person is excited. Oh, we are the ones championing the closure of this world. Glory be to God. We're the ones championing the closure. Amen. This was one of such things that my son had me preaching one day, and he started crying. He said, why would Jesus destroy this world? He's still enjoying ice cream, cake, and all the manner of them. He doesn't see any reason why Jesus should destroy the world yet. Hallelujah. Glory be to God. He's just a kid. But I tell you, there are some adults that are equally crying. They panic in their heart whenever they hear this kind of gospel. They are afraid because they don't want to die. They want to enjoy the world. Praise the Lord. There is nothing to enjoy in this world. What we have here is tribulation. Do you know? What we have here is what? Tribulation. That's what we have. Do you know what is tribulation? Praise the Lord. When you hear tribulation, some people think it's only when demons are chasing you or when things are not working the way they ought to work. Whether things are working or not working, it's still tribulation. Do you know? Praise the Lord. It doesn't matter whether it's working or it's not working. It's still tribulation. Amen. You are troubled by both good and evil. The trouble that man has is because of the knowledge of good and evil. Ever since that man ate of the fruit of that tree, his troubles has never ceased. Amen. That knowledge will forever remain a problem for man. Forever. God said, the day you eat of this fruit, you are going to die. Isn't that what he said? So it will forever remain a problem. That's why Jesus, you know, Jesus can't contradict the Father. He said, in this world you will have what? Tribulation. He said, but be of good cheer, I have overcome the world. In me, you are going to have what? Peace. Only in me. Praise the Lord. It didn't say that in abundance of riches and wealth. Eh? In abundance of riches and wealth, you will have peace. No. He said, in me, you will have peace. Not in abundance of riches and wealth. One program they were advertising, they said, if you are interested in riches, wealth, health, come over to our place. Amen. I said, that's the word. That's the word that they are offering. They can't offer anything more than riches, wealth, and health. And men rush, praise the Lord. Men rush for such places where they are offered riches, wealth, and health. What a powerful combination. Once you have it, your problems will be over. The Bible says that the sleep of a laboring man is sweet, whether he eats little or much. He said, but the abundance of the rich will not suffer him to sleep. When goods increase, the man that will eat it will also increase. When you are celebrating the goodness of the Lord upon your life, in that he has blessed you with the things of this world, the evil ones will also be celebrating the goodness of the Lord for them, because yet another opportunity for their good to come. Praise the Lord. Ah, they will be celebrating. Now, write down, Macau. I got a target here. Hallelujah. Glory be to God. Hallelujah. So, whilst you are celebrating your own, doing Thanksgiving, they too are also doing Thanksgiving. Amen. Because if you don't have anything, they won't have anything to come and take now. Praise the Lord. Amen. Glory be to God. In this world, you will have tribulation. Our confidence is not in anything in this world. Not in good, not in evil. Hallelujah. In me, you will have peace. You will have what? Peace. Oh, but men have forsaken their mercies and they are busy observing lying vanities. They are forsaking the sure mercies of God. Hallelujah. I tell you the truth, until you give in to what the word of God is saying, man, you are going to be troubled. Hallelujah. Do you know many people have lost their lives chasing after good? Is that not tribulation? They are busy chasing good. And in the process, they've lost their lives whilst chasing after good. It's not. Many have exposed themselves to so many frustrations, disappointments, and all the manner just because of what? Good. I don't know which good you are looking for. Is it the Lord Jesus Christ? Or you are looking for the good of the world? Amen. Where is your rejoicing? Christ? Your rejoicing is Christ? Hallelujah. Amen. They that love the Lord will always rejoice in the Lord Jesus Christ. They that love God. But those that don't love God, when you try to tell them that gaining this world is not a part of the package, they get offended. Praise the Lord. Because in the first place, the reason why they are shouting hallelujah and praising God is because of the worldly package that they are expecting. Is it not? So when they are told that it is not part of the package, They get offended. They are not interested anymore. Hallelujah. Does that prove that they love the Lord Jesus? Huh? He said, we are of the circumcision, which worship God in the spirit and rejoice in the Lord Jesus, and have no confidence whatsoever in the flesh. Glory be to God. I say glory be to God. No confidence whatsoever in the... I mean, of what good is it to you putting your confidence in something that you have been told that you will only have tribulation in? Praise the Lord. What purpose does this have to, you know, to you? None. Praise the Lord. Absolutely none. Amen. You better put your confidence in the Lord Jesus Christ. Better put your confidence in Jesus, so that you will avoid many pains and sorrows. It's not what the Bible says. It says they that have been busy pursuing after riches. It says they have fallen into many diverse temptations and what? And foolish and hurtful lusts, which drown men in what? Perdition and destruction. Praise the Lord. Do you need all that trouble? Amen. Or you think you will be smart? Praise the Lord. That because it's you, you have understanding, it will not create problem for you. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. You don't need all that sorrow. You don't need all that. There are so many things that people pray for. You don't need to pray. Amen. All you need to do is to obey the word of God. And the stress and the sorrow will go. So many are suffering, are ill, sick, because of good. Good is giving them sickness. Praise the Lord. Yeah. If you go to Psychia now, you have 85% of the people there are there because of good. Amen. You don't know that good gets one mad. You don't have it, you get mad. You feel frustrated. And then you tell yourself, life is not fair unto you. You know? Because the people around you will not even make matters easy for you. Because the moment you don't have good, you won't have any respect in the society. Praise the Lord. Nobody will respect you. Worse still, if you are the firstborn, you will become lastborn. Because the others have overtaken you. Amen? And then you begin to ask yourself, what kind of life is this? And then some false individuals, some false prophets will tell you, it's a curse. Amen? They tell you it's a curse. Come, let us break the curse for you. You need 40 days fasting and prayer. Amen. So that you can tear down the walls of darkness that are standing against your breakthrough. Glory be to God. I don't know. Ever since I realized that the things of this world, that they are vanity, I stopped binding the devil. Praise the Lord. Amen. What are you binding him for? That's waste of prayer. So that you receive what? It doesn't make sense. I get in the point. I can bind and lose if it concerns the Lord Jesus Christ. But if it comes to this world, take. Hallelujah. If we are in the process of getting the word, then we won't be here now. Praise the Lord. No, take. But then, when I didn't have understanding, it was a big deal. Praise the Lord. I will engage in all manner of prayers. Strategic warfare for financial abundance. I used to have all manner. Strategic warfare for financial abundance. And then I will reference some relevant scriptures and do some midnight intercession. Binding and losing and, you know, tearing down all the forces of darkness that are standing against my breakthrough and my prosperity. Hallelujah. Amen. I used to engage in all manner. Praise the Lord. Everybody that is standing against the contract or your breakthrough becomes a devil. Amen. And you want to kill them so that you gain the world. It doesn't make sense. You know? You give yourself sleepless night for rubbish. It dawned on me one day. I said, who is it that the unbelievers pray to? Which God do they pray to? Do you understand what I'm saying? Which God are they praying to? Because they have all the money. If money is what I'm looking for, I should go and know the God that they are, you know, praying to, so that that same God can give me the money. You know, the day I got angry was the day it dawned on me that unbelievers don't pray anything, and yet they swim in the money. Yeah? Praise the Lord. And I realized that I've been wasting my time on rubbish. Praise the Lord. Yeah. Ever since the Lord opened my eyes, it became crystal clear to me. And I don't bother myself about praying for those things. I don't pray for breakthrough. I don't pray for prosperity. I don't pray for those things. Can we turn our Bibles to Matthew chapter 18? Some people, when you tell them things like this, they will say, if you don't pray now, how will the thing happen? Which thing? If those things are the blessing. Yeah? If the things of this world, if they are the blessing, then I don't need it. Praise the Lord. If the things of this world are the blessing, I don't need it. Amen. Do you hear what I said? I said, if the things of this world are the blessing, I don't need it. Can you make that confession of faith? Praise the Lord. If it's a blessing, I don't need it. I can't be afraid that I won't receive, I won't have a breakthrough. What am I doing with it? Amen? No. It was in those days when I didn't know anything. Praise the Lord. Don't look at, I'm not saying anything strange, because I don't know which prosperity that Lazarus was looking for at the rich man's gate. Yeah? A man that settled for crumbs at the rich man's gate every day. Somebody told me, he said Lazarus is a bad example of a believer, a hero of Christ, a celebrated hero of Christ. Somebody opened his mouth to say that Lazarus is a bad example, or is a mediocre. He's a bad example of a believer. A celebrated hero of Christ. Okay, now, when the rich man told Abraham about what he was going through, Abraham said, whilst you were here, you enjoyed good. Isn't that what he said here? That's what the Bible said. He said the rich man enjoyed good and Lazarus evil. But now the tables have turned. Amen? He said the tables have turned. Now, Lazarus is enjoying the real good, the true good. Yeah? And this one is now enjoying the true evil. Praise the Lord. Yeah. But that time that they were here on earth, who would even recognize how many people even recognize the face of Lazarus? Amen. The one that received the blessing found himself in hell. The one that didn't receive the blessing found himself in the kingdom of God. Men, if the things of this world are the blessing, I don't need it. I don't need it. I'm telling you the truth. I don't need it. I don't need it, and I can't be crying to God for it. No way. When you understand what these things are, you don't give yourself stress. I'm telling you the truth. The problem why we struggle in our relationship with God is because of the influence of religion upon our lives. Religion has taught us so many things that are not of God, that are not true concerning God, which are not the righteousness of God. And because of it, anytime the truth of God's word is coming, it sounds strange to our ears. Because religion has influenced us wrongly. Do you understand what I'm saying? To believe and have value for things that we should not have value for. That's what the system of the world has been trying to do all our lives. To get us to believe in it and have confidence in it. And because that system of the world has also permeated into the religious institutions, they have carried the same, you know, wrong teachings and values into the church. And so men cannot trust God anymore because they don't understand that God is more than these physical things that they are seeing. Praise the Lord. I tell you the truth, Lazarus never knew that he was suffering. Does that sound strange to you? He never knew he was suffering. You know, the joy of the Lord was his strength. Christ was the reason for his rejoicing. How will he know that he's suffering when he's always rejoicing in the Lord Jesus Christ? He doesn't know what he's going through. Praise the Lord. He said, for our light affliction is but for a moment, which worketh out in us a far more exceeding and eternal weight of glory. Praise the Lord. That's what is working out in us. And so we rejoice. Why we look not at the things which are seen, for the things which are seen are temporal. But that which is not seen is what? Eternal. We're not looking at things which are seen. We are looking at that which is not seen. Glory be to God. And that which is not seen is the reason for our rejoicing. That which is not seen is our confidence. Hallelujah. That which is not seen is our peace. Glory be to God. I say glory be to God. That's where our confidence is. Not in the physical things of this world. That's where the enemy keeps battling. Because as long as he can get us into that realm, he's able to trouble our mind. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. The peace which the Lord has given unto you, no man shall take it away from you. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. My brethren, please, I'm begging you in the name of Jesus Christ, not to put your confidence in anything in this world. Don't mind the false teachings that are going on in the world today. Some are preaching that you gain the world, then eventually you get to heaven. You gain the world and then eventually end up in heaven. When Jesus has already told you, what shall it profit a man to gain the world and to lose his soul? Now they are preaching, gain the world and then eventually see yourself in heaven. How possible is it? Why would people know when they are being deceived and when they are being lied to? Jesus never talked about gaining this world. Praise the Lord. He didn't talk about gaining the world. So I don't care who you are. What are you telling me? You gain the world and then at the end of the day you gain Christ. It's a lie. It is a big lie. Lie from the pit of hell. Men that are in Christ don't gain the world. Are you hearing what I'm saying? If the reason why you are here is to gain the world, you are in the wrong place. Amen? We don't gain the world here. What we gain here is Christ. And that's what the scripture says. And that's what Christ taught us. Not that you gain the world and then eventually you end up in heaven. That's a lie from the pit of hell. Gain the world and then at the end of the day, you end up in heaven. It's a lie. Christ did not come so that we will gain the world. No. He came so that we will gain him and him alone. Praise the Lord. Peter came to Jesus and he said, we have left all. We have left all. Did he leave all in order to gain the world? No. He said, we've left all. Glory be to God. May that be your testimony. I said, may that be your testimony. He said, we have left all to follow you. We have left all to follow you. Jesus said, if any man will come after me, and then will look back. He said, that man, put his hands in the floor and look back. He said, that man is not fit for the kingdom of God. There is nothing like gaining the world and then at the end of the day you end up in heaven. That's a lie from the pit of hell. Men that are in Christ don't gain the world. Men that are in Christ are men and women that have left the world. Hallelujah. That's who they are. Are you getting the point? The reason why they are in Christ is that they have seen that there is nothing to gain in the world. That's the reason why they are in Christ in the first place. Because their eyes have opened to see that there is nothing to gain in the world. That's why they are believers. If not, they are unbelievers. That's why John said, love not the world, nor the things in the world. For what is in the world is the lust of the eyes, the lust of the flesh, the pride of life. He said, all these things are not what? Of the Father. They are not of who? The Father. What are you telling me? They are not of the Father. He that loves the world, the love of the Father is not in him. Not to gain the world. Hallelujah. Glory be to God. They say, but John said, I wish above all things that thou mayest be in health and prosper, even as thy soul prospereth. Yes! It's not different from what Jesus said. Seek ye first the kingdom of God and his righteousness, and every other thing that you need shall be added unto you. Which is not different from what Apostle Paul said. He said, for godliness with contentment is what? Great gain.
Therefore, having food and raiment, be what? Content. So when God is saying, brethren, I wish above all things that thou mayest prosper. What is he saying? That thou mayest have food and raiment and be what? Content. That's what he's saying. It's not outside there. He said, they that will be rich. You know what he said? They that will be rich will do what? Will fall into many diverse temptations and into many foolish and hurtful lusts, which drown men in perdition and destruction. So where did they bring that gospel of gaining the world, the gospel of prosperity? Praise the Lord. That's not what Christ is preaching. A man's life does not consist in the abundance of things he possesses. The scriptures abound. The scriptures abound with the righteousness of God. I'm not talking about gaining the world. Well, I don't care who you are. I don't care that miracles you are doing. Praise the Lord. Jesus is not talking about gaining the world. Let's look at that Matthew chapter 18 from verse 6. It said, but whoso shall offend one of these little ones which believe in me, it were better for him that a millstone were hanged about his neck and that he were drowned in the depth of the sea. He said, woe unto the world! Woe unto you false prophets because of offenses. For it must needs be that offenses come. But woe to that man by whom the offense cometh. You tell me you are anointed. Anointed to preach rubbish. Look at what Jesus is saying concerning the little ones that believe in him. He said, it were better for you that a millstone were hanged about your neck and that you were drowned in the depth of the sea. That you should be the one bringing an offense unto the children of God. The gospel which they preach, tagging it the gospel of the kingdom of God, is an offense. It's an offense. Offense unto the children of God. Because it is a message which they preach that does not build unto eternal life. It's a message that sets men on the path of destruction and hell. And Jesus is warning. Yes, I know offenses will come. But woe unto you if you are the one that will be responsible for being an offense unto these little ones. Glory be to God. I say glory be to God. He said, gain the world and then eventually end up in heaven. It's a lie from the pit of hell. Even you that is preaching it, you know it's a lie. Solomon said, I give my heart to be all I can be and get all I can get. At the end of the day, I saw it was all vanity and vexation of the spirit. And I saw that there was no profit in all these things. Are you getting the point? I saw that there was no profit whatsoever in all those things. And then you are telling me, gain the world and then gain the kingdom of God. It's a lie. Jesus said, what shall it profit you to gain the whole world and to lose your soul? You don't gain the world in Christ. No. That message is an offense. If you are luring people away, making them to believe in Christ, because you are promising them that when they come to Christ, they are going to gain the world, you are a deceiver. You better tell men the truth. If they want to love Christ, they will love him. If they don't want to love him, they will continue in their evil ways, and at the end of the day, they will end up in hell. Praise the Lord. Paul, talking about such men, he said, whose God is their belly? They preach from their belly. The only reason why they preach such messages is because of what they are going to gain from you. Praise the Lord. Amen. Glory be to God. Oh, Jesus is Lord. He said, if anyone will offend any of those little ones which believe in me, it were better for him that a millstone were hanged about his neck and that he were drowned in the depth of the sea. Woe unto the world because of offenses, for it must needs be that offenses come. But woe to that man by whom the offense cometh. It's a woe unto that man by whom the offense cometh. Praise the Lord. Let's look at Matthew chapter 16 from verse 21 so we understand better what these offenses are. From that time forth began Jesus to show unto the disciples how that he must go unto Jerusalem and suffer many things of the elders and chief priests and scribes, and be killed and be raised again the third day. Then Peter took him and began to rebuke him, saying, be it far from thee, Lord, this shall not be unto thee. But he turned and said unto Peter, get thee behind me, Satan, thou art an offense unto me, for thou serverest not the things that be of God, but those that be of men. Then said Jesus unto his disciples, if any man will come after me, let him deny himself and take up his cross and follow me. For whosoever will save his life shall lose it, and whosoever will lose his life for my sake shall find it. For what is a man profited if he shall gain the whole world and lose his own soul? Or what shall a man give in exchange for his soul? For the Son of Man shall come in the glory of his Father with his angels, and then he shall reward every man according to his works. Verily I say unto you, there be some standing here which shall not taste of death till they see the Son of Man coming in his kingdom. Praise the Lord. Can you see what I'm talking about? Praise the Lord. Can you see what I'm talking about? When any man is saying to you the things that men savor, and they are presenting it to you as the righteousness of God, what those people are unto you are an offense. Praise the Lord. They are an offense unto you because they don't savor the things of God. Are you getting the point? Because if they savor the things of God, they will know that it is not about gaining the world. Praise the Lord. But because people lack understanding, when they talk about gaining the world, you know, they open their hearts unto them, thinking that probably this man loves me. That's why he wants me to gain the world. Are you getting the point? But the truth of the matter is that, look at Peter. Peter was fighting and was saying, no, God forbid that Jesus should die. In the eyes of you and I, what Peter is saying looks good. Are you getting the point? If Jesus were to be, you know, one that is not walking in the spirit, he would more or less give in to what Peter is saying. But because he's a man under the, you know, influence of the Spirit, he was able to see through Peter immediately and realize that Peter was not speaking what the Lord was saying. He was only saying what man wanted him to say. Are you getting the point? And which is the case today. They don't savor the things of God. So because they are, you know, Jesus was talking about how he was going to be arrested and killed and then rise up on the third day. No, this man can't love himself. Are you getting the point? How is he going to work out? We better quit this process. Yeah? No, it can't be. It's not the intention of God for you. It's not the plan of God for you. God cannot allow you to suffer these things in the hands of chief priests and be killed. And then on the third day, you are going to rise up again. But what he was talking about was the things of men. Now we are talking about Christ not coming that we may gain the world. It looks as if what we are saying is out of this world. Praise the Lord. Yeah? Because it's not about gaining the world. So that cannot be the things of men. Are you getting the point? The things of men are all about gaining the world. But now we are talking about, you know, not getting the world, which has to do with severing the things of Christ. And then Peter is saying to Jesus, God forbid that should be the case. God forbid that you should not gain the world. Somebody prayed a prayer for the congregation I had sometime. He said, you will not die a poor man. Is that a prayer? You will not die a poor man. How is that a prayer? This is a so-called giant of the Lord. Great man of God. You will not die a poor man. And some fools were shouting, amen. Is that a prayer? They don't savor the things of God, but the things of men. Are you getting a point? So when they talk about the things of men,
The fools there will say, hey, amen, because they don't end their life from their right. What is that? You die the poor man, you die the rich man. Of what difference does it make? Does it make any difference? That's not a prayer. So he's not praying for you. You will not die a poor man. No, listen to the prayer. You will not die a poor man and you are shouting amen. You will die a rich man like that rich man that died and went to hell. That's what he said. You will not die a poor man, but you're going to die a rich man and end up in hell. He didn't say that, but that's what he's saying, in other words. Do you know? Do you know that's what he's saying? You will not die a poor man, and you are shouting amen. But all he has told you is that you will die a rich man and go to hell. Eh? He didn't tell you that. Did he tell you that Jesus told, when that rich man came to Christ, do you know what Jesus said? He said, how hardly shall a rich man enter into the kingdom of God? And then when he said it and the disciples didn't hear, he looked to him as if the disciples didn't understand what he said. He said, it is again, listen, I'm saying to you again so that you hear what I'm saying clearly. It is easier for a camel to pass through the eye of a needle than for a rich man to enter into the kingdom of God. And then somebody is telling you, you will not die a poor man. What is that man sentencing? Where is that man sentencing you to? Hell. Because he has just told you that you will not die a poor man. And you just simply said amen. Did he tell you when you die, where you are going to? Or you have just assumed that when you die, you will go to heaven. God have mercy. He said, these men don't savor the things of God, but the things of men. Jesus said to Peter, you are an offense unto me. Offense. So any man that is preaching the word to you is an offense unto you. That man is destroying you, but you don't know. You think he's doing good to you because he's telling you about how you will get the word. But what he's doing to you is that he's sentencing you to hell. That's what he's doing. Because when you become rich, like he's promising you that God is going to make you rich, and then you become rich, and then those things that you have gotten rich in will fill your heart and take every space that the Lord Jesus Christ will take in your life. And then where are you going to end up? Hell. Peter said to Jesus, we have left houses, everything. We have left all and followed thee. Jesus said, no man that has left houses, lands, wife, children, husband, or the manor, will not in this world receive a hundredfold. And in the world to come, life everlasting. Do you know what they said? Do you know what they said there now? You know, praise the Lord. One time I was referencing this scripture to one pastor like that. And then he said to me, hey now. I said, okay, what of Peter then? Where did they receive the hundredfold? He said, can't you see that after that Christ left, people were selling their houses, their lands and everything, and they were bringing it, and they had so many people, people were giving their lives in multitude, and those people that were giving their lives became their father and mother and the rest of them. I said, is that true? I said, what of wives? Hundredfold. That means that now, since they left their wives, now they're going to receive wives now in hundredfold. Since they have received parents, hundredfold, mothers, hundredfold, children, hundredfold. What of wives? He now shut up. See, Christ wasn't talking about, they didn't leave those things in order that they will receive lands and houses in hundredfold here on earth. Are you getting the point? What Jesus was simply telling them, that when you forsake all, you become a candidate of bearing 100% fruit here on earth. Praise the Lord. Are you getting the point? Because it is in this earth that you bear fruit hundredfold. It's not in the world to come that you will bear fruit. It is in this world. That's what he's saying. When you forsake these things, when you forsake houses, wife, land, children, or money for Christ, for the kingdom of God's sake, he said, in this world, you will receive hundredfold. What happens is that when you do that, when you have left all, and for the sake of the kingdom, automatically your heart goes out to Christ completely to do the biddings, his biddings, all the days of your life, and thereby making yourself a candidate of receiving or bearing that 100% fruit here on earth, which eventually translates into eternal life in the world to come. Glory be to God. That's what he's saying. He's not talking about gaining the world, but some perverse individuals. That's what Paul called them. Paul called them perverse individuals. destitute of the truth, who suppose that gain is godliness. Say, they are destitute of the truth, perverse in their minds, who preach that gain is godliness. It's not godliness. Do you understand what I'm saying? It's not. That's not what he's talking about. We are blessed with all spiritual blessings in the heavenly places. Amen. So that's why Jesus, and remember, it was Peter that he was talking to. He said, if any man will come after me, let him deny himself and take up his cross and follow me. If you try to gain your life, you will lose it. Did you hear what I said? Men that are believers that follow Christ are no more in it to gain the world. Do you hear what I'm saying? You are no more in Christ to gain the world. If you are in Christ and you are still looking to gain the world, my brethren, I tell you the truth, you have missed it. He said, they that are in him will do what? Deny themselves, take up their cross, and follow him. He said, if you try to gain your life afterwards, you are going to lose it. Who is he talking to? The disciples. Eh? Not unbelievers. Was he talking to unbelievers? He's talking to who? The believers. That if you try to gain your life, you will lose it. If you try to gain this world, you will lose your life. So whoever that is telling you that you can gain this world and then eventually you will gain the kingdom of God is lying to you and is programming you for hell and destruction. They say, but if you will lose your life, hallelujah, if you will lose your life, yeah? If you will leave all, just like the apostles left all, yeah? If you will conclude and take a decision in your heart, I'm not in this thing to gain the world. If you will do that, Christ says you are going to gain your life. Hallelujah! You are going to gain life eternal in the name of Jesus. For what will it profit a man to gain the whole world and to lose his soul? Any man that is preaching anything to you, telling you about how you are going to gain this world, that man is an offense unto you and is setting you on a path of destruction and hell. Praise the Lord. Oh, hallelujah. Glory be to God. I say glory be to God. Telling you about how you gain the world. Because you don't have understanding. You think that what that individual is saying to you is about eternal life. No. Eternal life is different from gaining this world. Do you understand what I'm saying? Now hear me and hear me well. It is very possible for you to gain this world with or without God. As a matter of fact, you don't need God to gain the world. Do you understand what I'm saying? You don't need God to gain the world. Unbelievers have gained the world without God. Eh? And many of them are avowed Satanists. They proclaim publicly that they worship Satan. There are so many companies like that. Some time ago, they sent me some article listing a number of companies that they said those Satanists owned, that we should not be patronizing their products. Lie, I still patronize them. Hallelujah. Yeah, he said you shouldn't patronize their products. Yeah, that's what I'll now be going to the chef and be looking. Is this one Satanist or no? What it concern me? Yeah? Did God stop them? God didn't stop them. They are known Satanists. They say Satan is their God. Yeah, and they have all the money in this world. What are you talking about? You say the mission of God is now to stop them. That's not the mission of God. The mission of God is to give life. That's why when David got confused in Psalm 73, he got confused. He saw that the unrighteous were prospering and having it all in the world, and he got confused, you know. But when he went into the sanctuary of God, he realized that he was like a beast before God. Even to consider to think that God was all about, you know, making men to gain the world. Are you getting the point? He said he didn't know that he was like a beast before God, to think that the blessing is about the things of the world. And when he realized it, he kept quiet. Because since the things of this world, gaining the things of this world is not the blessing, it doesn't matter who gains it, whether the righteous or the unrighteous. At the end of the day, what matters is, where are they ending up? Praise the Lord. So you're telling me that we have been called to gain the world? No, I tell you, that's a lie. The reason that why Christ came for you and I is that we will gain eternal life. The Bible also told us clearly, you know, say in John 3:16, he said, "For God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten son, that whosoever believeth unto him will do what? Will have what? Life everlasting." Did he say he will gain the world? He said he will have life everlasting. So why did we now switch that life everlasting and assume that life everlasting is about gaining the world? Why are we perverting the truth of God's word? Why are we saying what God didn't say in his word? Praise the Lord. In the whole of the Bible, from Genesis to Revelation, it has always been Christ. Praise the Lord. When God was talking about blessing in the Old Testament, he wasn't talking about physical things. Though that one, the Bible says that while they read the law, the veil covered it. Are you getting the point? The veil covered it. So what God was talking about was Christ. The law was all about Christ. Are you getting the point? So even if he was talking about the things of this world to be blessing in the Old Testament, he was still talking about the Lord Jesus Christ. But he said, because while the law was read, the veil covered it. But he said, in Christ, the veil has been taken away. Hallelujah. So that when we read the old, the new, what we are seeing as a blessing is the Lord Jesus Christ. Hallelujah. Glory be to God. I say, glory be to God. Glory be to God. Glory be to God. No wonder that Apostle Paul declared, and he said, "I have fought the good fight of faith. I have finished my course. I have kept the faith. And now is left for me a crown of glory, which the Lord shall give, not only unto me, but unto all those that love his appearing." Come on, shout a big hallelujah to God. Stand on your feet and give him praise this morning. Give him praise this morning. Glory be to God. I say, glory be to God. Hallelujah to God. Glory, glory, glory be to God. Oh, Father, we give you praise. We give you praise. We give you praise. Oh, blessed be your name. Blessed be your name. Oh, we thank you. We thank you. We thank you.